All right, we do have James Spader. He's ready to come in tonight. This show comes on called Blacklist. It's the second season. And from my understanding, we're finally going to be fighting Berlin this year. I know, when I say Berlin, what do you think of, Chris?
Germany?
You're wrong.
Oh, it's not Germany?
No, we thought that for a long time. Blacklist airs Mondays, 10 o'clock. Let's bring in the one and only, James Spader. Blacklist is back tonight, and it looks like all hell is breaking loose there. And James Spader is in studio with us. How are you, sir?
I'm doing very well, thank you.
You know, this character that you play, it always makes me laugh that this is the type of thing that never would have been on television years ago. You know, it's so, it's such a complicated guy, and violence can break out very, very quickly.
Yes.
Television for you is something you've been able to go back and forth between TV and movies.
Yeah, I've been very lucky in the last five... 6 years I've been able to, finished doing a television show for a while and then came to New York, did a play for a year, David Mamet play, Race, then went back and did a little visit on The Office for a year, and they were nice enough to let me out to go and do the Lincoln film with Steven Spielberg and then The Blacklist. And then this spring, The Avengers again. So I've been able to jump around a lot, which has really been wonderful.
Well, that used to be, again, you would have to pick one of those paths.
They really do. Each of the businesses available to actors and everybody, writers, directors, producers, were finally delineated. You know, there was not a... People didn't move. They're very, very separate businesses. And that's changed now.
Well, you know, when you get to do like the big comic book film, but also get to do Mamet, also get to play this character which changes, moves around, and keeps everybody on edge because we don't know who this guy really is.
Right.
It's kind of good work everywhere.
Yeah, you know? No, I've been very lucky.
Yeah.
I mean, it's been, you know, this show, when looking for a television show to sign up for, you know, you're signing up for a period of time, and you don't know what the lifespan of that series may be.
It could be
6 months, or it could be, you know, 7 years or more. And so I'm always looking for something that's going to sustain, where it's still going to be surprising, it's still going to be able to, you're going to be able to cross a new threshold, even if you're in... season four.
Mm-hmm.
And this show, right from the pilot, when I first read it, I realized that the possibilities were limitless in terms of that.
Well, the thing is, too, we can watch the show and still not understand his motivations. That's part of the fun of what motivates this guy, other than we know, you know, he's fixated on this young girl, but we don't exactly know why. But then you think to yourself, what was he doing all these years before? What made him get up in the morning?
Yeah, you know? I love it. I love that the show allows for him to... I like it when our show shows him conducting his business concurrently while he's working with the FBI. And, you know, we were able to do that throughout season one, and I think we'll continue to do that in season two. And you know, also, I was very lucky. I worked for, I don't know, 6.5 years or something on a television show, the last year of The Practice, transitioning into Boston Legal. And in that show, the show was an amalgamation of very different things. You know, it was funny and silly and yet very dramatic and emotional at times. And so I was spoiled on that show because you were able to play a lot of things and it had a real surprising amount of variety. And even though it was within a fairly strict format or being a legal show. And so when looking for something that, you know, when I did The Office, it was great fun, but I knew what the entity was, and it was, and I also knew that it was a year.
Right.
But in looking for something that I was going to be joining for conceivably a period of time, I really wanted to find something where, as dramatic or dangerous or emotional as it may be, that it also have a real irreverence about it that really was part and parcel of how that character saw the world around him.
Yeah.
and how he lived. And this show has that.
And it's shot like a movie. You're in D.C., you're in New York, you're in planes. I mean, it's...
Yeah, this is the second season opens right away, yeah. overseas. And it, yeah, there's a lot of travel on the show, which I think is, the combination of our two companies that make our show, Sony being the studio that makes it and NBC being the network that broadcasts it, it was important to both of them that this have a real international presence. And I think that's probably become, so important in terms of the economics of television now.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that the international aspect of the show supports an audience overseas very, yeah. very, very well. I mean, this week on Wednesday, I go over to London and do an international press tour over there. I think the show just started airing in France this year. And people, as I said, when I was shooting the Avengers during the spring, I was in London, and the international audience for the show is as excited as the American audience is.
Well, I think they probably like the fact too that the American government is not necessarily the good guys in this too. Everything is gray.
Yeah, no everything
you
is
run
gray.
Into.
Yeah, everything yeah. is gray.
Doing the Avengers with Robert Downey Jr., you guys were kids together in the 80s, and now after, still doing stuff together.
It was really one of the nicest, for me, it was really, on a personal level, it was just, it was one of the most delightful aspects of doing the film was, he and I haven't seen Robert in some years. Our lives have been on two different paths, and it was just we started up right where we left off.
That's great,
and that was really one of the loveliest things about doing the film.
He's a guy that everybody always rooted for, even when he went through his troubles. And, I'm a recovery guy myself, so he's one of those guys that you could point out to people and say, look, it's never...
A tremendous success story.
Yeah, you can never count someone out because he had such a tough time. And now he's probably the biggest movie star on the planet and really takes care of everything around him, too.
Yeah,
you know, he's a good, responsible guy. The Blacklist airs Mondays on NBC, 10 o'clock. Season premiere airs tonight. Go to NBC.com for more information. And this is, this character is as complicated as everything goes on. You really do feel like you can get a long run out of it because it's moving at the speed of a movie.
Yeah.
Right now.
I mean, the first episode I just saw of this second season I just saw last night, and it's, the train leaves the station at full speed.
That's great.
Yeah.
Any more theater for you after doing the Mammoth that time?
If I get just even a moment break, that would be what I would love to do.
That's the first love for you, theater?
No, I really love, the reason why I say that is because after doing a television show, when I finished doing Boston Legal and I was sort of looking at films and, obviously the television community, there were things that I was looking at there. I just didn't arrive at anything that seemed right. And then this David Mamet play came along and I was very excited about it. And I realized in doing that, I hadn't done a play in many, many years. And I realized it was the perfect antidote to doing a television series for a bunch of years. It just is. It's such a different job. I mean, it as opposed to just volumes of material, mm-hmm. which is what you have with an hour long drama. Just it's a relentless amount of material. To be able to go and there's something very ritualistic about going and exploring the same piece of material. performance after performance and mining it for all it's worth.
Particularly with Mamet, I think, because every syllable is important
to
him.
Yeah, yeah. And it's his writing is very rhythmic and syncopated and therefore, like music, it can be reinterpreted from performance to performance, and just the smallest thing in terms of pace or in terms of changes everything.
Yeah.
So it was a great, great year. I really enjoyed it. And when I finish with this show, that's what I'll be looking for next.